Even though we're still in the throes of the spring calving season, it's not too early to begin thinking about the breeding season that's going to be coming up here, maybe in the middle of April, on into May and June, especially for those producers that are going to use artificial insemination, because quite frankly, we have to plan in advance of any AI breeding program, especially the estrus synchronization that we're going to use. Estrus synchronization is the situation, of course, where we're going to use one or more different kinds of products, working cattle through the chute one or more times before we actually do artificial insemination. Choosing which estrus synchronization protocol we're going to use on our place, it is really something that takes some real investigation and some serious thought. A way to get some help about which estrus synchronization protocol you want to use is by going online and looking up the estrus synchronization protocols that have been proposed by what's called the Applied Reproduction Task Force. That's a group of scientists from seven different universities around the country that all work in this area of cattle reproduction. And they have put together a list of this estrus synchronization protocols that they think work best in different situations. For instance, if you're more interested in being able to do a heat detection on your cows or heifers for a long period of time, say up to 2 weeks, then a simple synchronization protocol might work for you. If you're only willing to do heat detection for a few days, then another system may work best. And if you're one of those that just doesn't want to do heat detection at all, but wants to use timed AI, where everything is brought in on a given morning and everything is artificially inseminated that time, then of course you'll use a different system. Also, they categorize the different estrus synchronization protocols for replacement heifers, yearling replacement heifers, versus those that work best for mature cows that have calves nursing on them at the time of the AI breeding. And so you'll want to keep that in mind as well. Also, if you happen to have Brahma influenced cattle, they have a separate estrus synchronization system that research has shown has worked the best for that particular breed set. So I think if you'll go online and look up the Applied Reproduction Task Force, we've put a show link on the SUNUP website just so that you can go and look up those protocols that best fits your operation. And you'll also see some other fact sheets and some planning tools on that website that'll be really helpful to you if you're going to do AI this year. So I really recommend that you plan ahead. Go to the SUNUP website, that's sunup.okstate.edu, look under show links, and go to that link and study your lesson before you do your artificial insemination this year. Hey, we look forward to visiting with you again next week on SUNUP's Cow-Calf Corner.